Richard. Excellent. Look, I put a box full of your leftover things by the door.
Oh. Okay. I was actually wondering if it would be okay if I were to have my own office. I find sharing one with Bradley just incredibly distracting.
Fine. You're reassigned to the warehouse.
No, you're not sharing with Bradley. What's the problem?
Well, I just think that
Think that everybody would be much happier if you were in the warehouse? Now, why don't you get your shit and get out of my sight?
Oh, and Richard.
That'll be all.
Lower.
Sir, I'm not going any lower than that.
Oh.
That's right, I forgot you weren't Chad.
Hey, boss man!
Bradley! My number one guy! Listen, I want to congratulate you on that brilliant idea you had. What was that again?
Oh, thanks,
Never mind, that was some good work. So, as a reward, I'm giving you your own office. I reassigned Richard to the warehouse.
Wow! Thanks! Actually, I wanted to talk to you about Richard.
And?
Should she be hearing this?
Masseuse, will you be a doll and put on those headphones over there? I've got some business to conduct.
Sure.
Well?
Well, I know you gave Richard that job because you're a really great guy, but I don't think he's necessary.
Well, I can't get rid of him yet. It would look bad to the other employees.
Right, I know. I just thought if you gave me the authority, I could fire him.
Bradley, if anybody's going to fire him, it's going to be me. Besides, he's my mistake. My living fear.
Well, you shouldn't feel guilty. He did it to himself.
I know. I just didn't think I'd destroy him so easily. It would just be so much nicer if he would just disappear.
Disappear?
Yeah. Poof. Gone.
I see.
Tummy gurgle. You can come back now.
Hey, Earl, you busy?
A little bit, but that's okay.
Oh, never mind. I'll come back.
Did you need something?
I had these tickets to a musical, and I was going to go with one of my friends, but she canceled. And I was wondering if maybe you would like to go with me?
Oh, I don't know. I'm really more of a sports guy. Musicals aren't really my thing.
Oh, okay. No problem. I just thought I would ask.
I appreciate it.
Hey, Earl. Quick question.
Yeah?
Did your mom hold her breath the entire time she was pregnant with you?
Probably not.
Okay, I just figured the only reason you would have rejected Karen's offer is lack of oxygen at birth.
I just don't like musicals.
Dude, she wasn't asking you to a musical. She was asking you on a date.
Thank you.
Bradley! Why are you wearing trash bags? Is there a costume party or something?
No. But there will be celebrating after what I'm about to do.
Okay.
I have something that I've been wanting to say. I stand for justice. I stand for equality and honor. No longer will you trample over the little guys. No more will you be a thorn in the side of society. You have been found guilty and are condemned to death.
That's good. What is that, Shakespeare or something?
Oh my God.
Oh, you stabbed me! Ah! 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 That explains the trash bags.
What are you so pleased about?
Just happy to be here.
I know what you mean.
Long live the king, eh?
Yes, Earl. That's exactly right. Long live me. Agenda for today?
Today is our budget meeting. All right.
On the bulletin for today.
Well, we are still way over budget on our new manufacturing plant. The building is about 95% finished,
Richard!
But we are about 950%.
Little bird sat on a rocket ship, ready to fly. Little bird sat on a rocket ship, ready to fly. Big old rocket lifted up and birdie burned to a crisp in the sky. Hungry dog tied to a motorbike, eating a bun. Saw the bird burn in the morning light, touching the sun. Then hopped on his bike, growling, damn, birdies have all the fun. Good old Mother Nature gave Birdie a swan song to soar. He may be done with living, but it's the livers who keep begging.